Welcome to Villeneuve to Ask in France. Final day of the EuroLeague Women regular season, and what a regular season it has been. Only one game day left, and unbelievably, we still have three of the eight quarterfinal places up for grabs, with six teams still having a chance to claim a spot in the postseason this year. There are big games going on all over Europe tonight, and none bigger than our game right here as Villeneuve de Ascq take on Polkowice. A win for our hosts, and they are on their way to the quarterfinals. Slightly more complicated situation for Polkowice, with them having to win. Unless Virtus Bologna and Avenida both lose, then they would still go through even with a loss. But both these teams, both their coaches, will be 100% locked in. A win and they're in the quarterfinals. It is pretty straightforward equations here. Plenty of wrinkles going on around the rest of EuroLeague Women this evening. We do have a couple of games already in the books as Fenerbahce close out the regular season with their 12th win out of 14 games, 95-71 over DVTK. Both of those teams go through in Group A. Alongside them will be Skio in Group A, who are in action against Valencia at the moment, and they trail in that one. Another game in the books already this evening. Chukarova 56, Praha 77. Praha go through top of Group B. Chukarova will head through in second place. That one a little bit of a dead rubber for the final game of the regular season, as both those knew they'd qualified, knew where they were going to finish in the group. But both teams now getting into their final preparations here in France as they lock in for what is the biggest game of the season so far for both of these rosters. First, we will have our visitors, Polkowice, introduced to us here, and that roster certainly has plenty of firepower, and they shape up to try and outscore other teams rather than lock them down defensively. I wouldn't imagine that style of play will change here this evening as Polkowice come primed to put in some big numbers on the road. That said, they have stumbled their way towards the back end of the regular season. Lost their last three games against Chukarova, Gyor and Avenida last week. That one just by 5 points on their home floor. And with those losses, will have come an awful lot of nerves heading into this last game of the regular season. I imagine a few weeks ago, a month ago maybe, that this team thought that they were a shoo-in for the postseason. That is now hanging by a thread. However, plenty of talent in this roster. Brittany Sykes and Brianna Fraser have been leading the way for Polkowice this season, combining for over 30 points a game. Plenty of other talent in that roster as well for Coach Kowalewski to call upon throughout today's game. Polkowice now being introduced. As I say, a win for them and they will qualify for the playoffs. They will secure a quarterfinal berth. They'll also secure a quarterfinal berth with a loss, unless Virtus and Bologna, with a win, they'll qualify unless Virtus Bologna and Avenida both lose, and then that throws out their chances of being in the postseason. Home crowd filling up the stands. Going to be plenty of noise here when the game tips off. Lights go out as we get ready for the home team to be introduced. Villeneuve de Ascq certainly do prefer playing on this home floor, and no surprise with this crowd behind them. They've only lost one game in the EuroLeague Women here on their home floor. That was against Chukarova back on game day three. They will want to get the crowd involved early, make it a tough atmosphere for Polkowice to try and establish themselves in the game with him. And the French team, similar to Polkowice, will prefer a free-flowing, high-scoring game. And similar also to Polkowice, much of that scoring will be done inside or by getting themselves to the bucket. Due to the competitive nature of this final, day of the regular season. Three of the four Group B games are all tipping off at the same time. Avenida, Gyor, Virtus Bologna, Lens, and our game here, Villeneuve de Ask against Polkowice, all tipping off at exactly the same time. Teams getting themselves hyped for the game. And it's games like this that some players absolutely live for. Other players struggle under the pressure. I have a feeling both of these rosters have plenty of superstars that are ready to rise to the occasion here at game day 14 out of 14. Both teams now will enter into the final stages of their warm-up after a brief handshake on the half. Last time these two met, it was Polkowice who came away with a comfortable 16-point win. But you can tear that one up, throw it out the window, because we are in a do-or-die situation and all bets are off. All form is kind of ignored when you get to these one-and-done games. And it will come down to the team that deals with the pressure the best, that's likely to come away and be featuring in the quarterfinals in a few weeks' time. Three minutes now until our opening tip-off here. Here are our officials for this evening's game. Silvia Mazziali, Jose Pedroza, and Emmanuel Solakos from Italy, Portugal and Greece, respectively. Officiating crew are ready and commissioner is ready. Commentary team ready. And the players certainly look like they are pretty much locked in and ready to go as well. Crowd, as you would expect, a bumper crowd. Here's the starting five for Polkowice: Mavunga, Baric, Friskovets, Sykes and Fraser. Plenty for Coach Kovalevsky to work with. Some talent coming off the bench as well for Coach Kovalevsky. The experience of the likes of Gajda and Stankovic will certainly play their part in today's game. A good start, critical, I'm sure, for those teams, both sides of the floor. And I'm sure Coach Kovalevsky has put a game plan in place that will try and take the crowd out of the game early. But can his players execute in what's likely to be a hostile environment here? Here's the starting five for the home team: Zella, Smalls, Diaby, Burke and Salone. Again, strong five on the floor to start with, but Coach Mezia has plenty of talent from the bench to call upon as well. The likes of Soa Mbaka. Alio. Plenty coming off the bench for Coach Mezia. There is Coach Mezia, a Eurobasket Women gold medalist, leading the Belgian Cats to the Eurobasket crown in the summer in Ljubljana. A mild mannered, ponderous type of coach. He's not brash, he's not in your face. An absolute student of the game and a wonderful person to sit down and have a chat with for sure. Coach Kovalevsky taking every possible chance he can. As we see the ritual here in Villeneuve d'Ascq. Here comes the thunder clap. And whilst we have a few seconds before the start of the game, just a reminder, if you have your phones handy, do download the official EuroLeague Women app. It's completely free. And tons going on. Loads of videos, highlights, interviews, previews, reviews, and your live game stats as we progress through today's game. Burke will be going up for the tip for Villeneuve d'Ascq. One of several players that's featured in every single EuroLeague women game for the home team here this evening. What a game we've got. You look at the matchups here as well. Burke against Mavunga is going to be a hell of a matchup. Now have the ceremonial tip before we get the official tip here. And now we are ready for business. Game day 14. Final game of the regular season. Playoff quarterfinal space up for grabs here today in France. Polkowice will get the first possession of the game. Frischkowitz. Now into the hands of Sykes. Sykes tries to go backdoor to Frischkowitz. No good. Baseline ball for Villeneuve d'Ascq. Early on ball pressure being applied by Barrich. Slowing Zealous down. Down into the low post. Oh, bullying away to the basket. Not this time for Diaby. Drums ringing out around the arena and likely to do so for the majority of the game. Sykes puts it up. Off left, good defense. Frischkowitz will bring down the rebound, though, and Polkowice will go again. They look very composed here early on. Strong drive to the basket, ripped away by Burke. Out of bounds, though. Polkowice ball on the baseline. Barrich now. Baseline out of bounds. Play is poor. Picked off. Villeneuve d'Ascq go to the bucket. Foul's going to be called as Burke ends up on the floor. Foul called on Fraser. Smalls now at the top, pulls up, long, three ball is good. That's got the crowd into the game. Sykes now looking to feed the low post. Can they go to work close to the basket? Little pivot draws the foul off. Burke will head to the free throw line for shots. Brianna Fraser has had a strong season this season, averaging just shy of 15 points and over 6 rebounds a game. Actually part of the French League last season, so would have played against Villeneuve d'Ascq in the domestic competition. 2 from 2 from the free throw line. Gets Polkowice off to a start. Drive inside and the dump off. Oh, poor defense, but absolutely punished by smart offense. Mavunga, mid-range 2, short corner, no good. We feel that the home team have real confidence. Foul called on Barrich, the Slovenian magician. Player with unbelievable vision, just getting caught out this time defensively. Smalls again now. Offensive foul is going to be called against Burke. Against Diaby. 28-year-old just a little bit anxious to run away. Yeah, still fading on that screen. Home drums ringing out. Baric working hard to try and find the low post. Instead, the three ball will go up. That is smooth as silk from Stephanie Mavunga. Had 20 points against Avenida last week. Big time player for the big time part of the season. All tied at five here. 2.5 minutes gone. Three ball no good. Rebound pulled down one-handed. A little bit of shimmer and shine on that one. From Sykes, she hands it back now. Fraser for three, not the prettiest of shots. Remember, both these teams want to get out and score. That's their MO, that's how they like to play basketball. Attractive, fast, free flowing, get to the bucket. Big rebound though by Mavunga. Almost travels there. Looked like she picked up a pivot foot. No call. Sykes now against Smalls. Goes inside. Off the glass. That's a tough move by Brittany Sykes. She too had a big game last week. Had 22 points against Avenida. Step back not there for Smalls. Skip to the corner, three ball is there. Oh, string music from the corner. Zellers for the jumper. Blocking foul's gonna be called on Diaby. Two early fouls here. On the French big. Yeah, just leaning left. I see what the officials have called there. Footwork's pretty good, but the upper body's leaning outside of her cylinder. Diaby's not happy. Either way, Brianna Fraser, is heading to the free throw line. Diaby's going to have to come out of the game picking up that foul. Unbelievably, she's actually a very, very good defender. She's only averaging two fouls a game this season, so rare to see her in foul trouble. Gay comes in her place for Villeneuve Dask. First is good from Fraser, a 71% free throw shooter. Second no good, but it's off the hands of Burke, so Polkowice will regain possession. Little shake, little shimmy here. Friskovic's trying to get open. Hands it away to Barrett. Shot clock at four. Going to have to do something with it. They're going to turn it over. That's great defense by the French team. Wide open three ball. That comes up short for Salone. A little bit of pace coming into the game now. Catch and shoot. Zala Friskovic's off target. 35% three-point shooter, the Slovenian. Gay. Oh, nails a little elbow jumper. That is a smooth stroke from Aminata Gay. Two-point lead for Villeneuve Dask. Catch and shoot Mavunga. Not this time. Hit her last jumper. No good this time, though. Strong drive to the basket, but the defense had just about recovered in time. Sykes now leading the charge, a 4-on-2 break. Pulls the brakes on and pulls up for that little free throw line jumper. Not contested. And once again, we are tied. As expected, this game is nip and tuck so far in the first 5 minutes. Salone feeds it to the corner to Burke. Back to the basket, bully basketball coming off the left hand. A little heavy-handed from Gee. Catch and shoot corner, Friskovic's no good. Rebound by Salone. 22-year-olds had plenty of experience this season. Averaging just shy of 28 minutes a game at the highest level. That is only going to help her progression. Great defense here by Polkowice, chasing hard over and under every screen. Three ball goes up as the shot clock expires. Not this time for the home team. We're still tied at 10 apiece. Sykes backs it out, wants the screen from Mavunga. Step back, long two, off target. Good defense this time by Polkowice. Foul will be called on Prishkovets. Little crossover and a quick first step from Salone, enough to draw the foul. Prishkovets and Baric will head to the bench. Stankovic comes into the game. Gaida also in for her first taste of the action. Some experience on the floor for Polkowice. And now strong drive to the basket and one. That is a lightning first step to open up the lane. As soon as she swung through and got that first step, there really was, well, no other end to that play. Burke drawing the foul off Fraser and going to the line for the three-point play. Off left, though. Rebound almost falls kindly. It does. It's off the hands of Polkowice. So Villeneuve to ask will regain possession. Drums ringing out around the arena, incessantly, continuously pushing the home team forward. Lob pass inside, that's a poor pass really. Easily intercepted. Expecting better precision from Elio. Drive inside, Fraser gets locked up. Whose ball is it? It will remain Polkowice's ball. Tough for the official to see. His vision was impeded in that situation. Coach Mezian not happy. Stankovic now inbounds it to Banaszak. Gaida with possession. It's stolen away though. Good, quick hands by Burke. Hands it away. Elio, no good. And that is some fluid transition offense from the home team. They get out and run. Selfless play. Foul caught back into the play. Elio will head to the line for free throws. A 90% free throw shooter prior to today's game. The first is good. First points of the game for Caroline Alio. Breathes out and composes herself. Goes perfect from the line at her first trip. And the home team now with a 4-point lead over the Polish visitors. Stankovic sets the high screen, the switch is there, the pass is poor. Gerchen needed to let Gaida establish down in that low post. Stankovic established down in that low post. Timeout's been called here. 2 minutes 35 remaining in the first quarter. A home team, Villeneuve d'Ascq, lead this one 14-10 over Polkowice.
ball. Time for up. I want you to find the ball up for her. Okay? Four up. Here we go. That way, that way, that way.
Early timeout called there by Coach Kowalewski. These type of games are the narrowest of margins. Clearly felt that maybe Villeneuve d'Ascq getting a little bit of control in this game. Lisowa Mbaka into the game for the first time today. Gets her hands on the ball, drives inside, draws a foul. Lands hard though. On the floor in some pain, weaves away inside. Stankovic comes across to put some rim protection in, but can only foul her. Oh, she's in some pain. Back on her feet though. That is a warrior. We'll head to the free throw line. 22-year-old. ...61% this season from the free throw line. Double change here for Villeneuve d'Ascq as Mananga comes in and Smalls returns. Betty Mananga. Coach Mezian making some changes in this first quarter. Fatigue will certainly play a part in this game. It's been a long regular season, both domestically so far and in EuroLeague Women's. Back. Manages to split the free throws, hits the second after missing the first. Game high lead now for Villeneuve d'Ascq. 5-point lead, a little over 2 minutes left in the first quarter. Sykes now uses the pivot beautifully and gets the score. Starting to look a little bit too easy for Brittany Sykes. Stolen away, telegraphed the pass out of the low post. Great. Gaida now. Travelling violation going to be called and just caught in two minds. Manashak. 23-year-old wasn't sure whether to shoot, whether to drive. It's going to earn her a trip back to the bench, though, as Coach Kowalewski makes the change. Elio kicks it out. Suwumbaka, Elio back out. Not this time. Feel that Polkowice have maybe increased a little bit of the energy levels on the defensive end. Nice pass inside. Oh, that is a beautiful pass and a strong finish by Fraser. She's up to 5 points personal and three rebounds now, Brianna Fraser. Quick first step again, kicked out. Wonderful footwork by Smalls, drives inside, it's out. Alio for three, short again. They're creating the options, just not quite getting the finish as of yet. Three ball goes up, string music. This time for Camia Smalls. James Madison graduate, getting it done here on the biggest stage. Sykes now, slowing things down. 6.5 seconds difference between the shot clock and the first quarter clock. Sykes with the three ball, comes up short. Where's the rebound? Oh, Gaida doesn't give up on it, hustles it down. Sykes will go again and she'll get the score. Wow, what a way to close out the first quarter. That score from Sykes brings Polkowice back to within two. As expected, this one is a close one. Villeneuve d'Ascq, 18. Polkowice, 16. 10 minutes in the book. A huge 30 minutes still ahead of us. What a game already. The home team with the narrowest of margins after the first quarter.
mettre ce soir à l'honneur le centre de formation et le staff. Mesdames et messieurs, j'aimerais, alors je vais citer le nom un par un, donc on a au staff, mesdames et messieurs, monsieur Kevin Fauchois, Iliès Dekil, Christine Paré et Léo Ozar. Mesdames et messieurs, pour les joueuses, la Toulouse, Clara Causeur, Chloé Pinel, Tilea Sanson, Charlotte Aman, Aziz Leguen, Marlène Blé, Harold Franck, Peyton de Bobonagé, Elodie Luther, Eva Bach, Lise Vanning, Tina Torsi, Jacques, Bourbozo Maeva, Contrôlé, Maureen Caru, Eva Hidal, Alissa Mendy, Aman Veillard, Lady, James, Louise Vienna, Astrid, Boukouloupé. Et bien, c'est sûr, je vous rappelle également que les espoirs joueront National 1, que c'est le seul centre de formation en France qui évolue à ce niveau. Et également les 18 joueront les 18. Mesdames et messieurs, je vous remercie, s'il vous plaît, avoir une ovation.
Well, this game is living up to all of the hype. Expected these two to go toe-to-toe. They certainly have in the first quarter. 18-16 in favour of Villeneuve d'Ascq. Expect a second quarter just as close. It's two evenly matched teams who play a very similar style of basketball. Trade blows here in France. Thrown away, though. First play of the second quarter. Polkowice are certainly in the ascendancy as we closed out that first period. Brittany Sykes trying to take the game on her own shoulders. Pass inside. Oh, that is a tough play. That is just about physicality from Brianna Fraser. Draws the body contact, gets the score and will go to the line. Draws contact from two players. Doesn't take her eyes off the bucket for a second. At the line for a chance at the bonus. Already on 7 points, Fraser. A real handful, the 26-year-old. And converts the three-point play. Polkowice are now with a one-point lead. Zelos comes up short. French team starting to rely on the outside, out of the races though. Score is good. Smart play by Koshler. Look at the pace both these teams want to play this game at. Gotta love how fast they want to play. Oh, the three is good now though. This time it's Kennedy Burke, 32% three-point shooter, averaging nearly 16 points a game, a UCLA graduate. Stankovic trying to find space. Foul's going to be called on Smalls. Galeda just gets there in time and draws the foul. We're all tied up at 21 apiece here. Stankovic comes back to Galeda. Back inside to Stankovic, little fade away, no good. Where's the rebound? Foul will be called, I think, on Dragana Stankovic. Second foul of the quarter for Villeneuve d'Ascq. First foul of the quarter for Polkowice. Almost stolen away, just holds on to it, kicks it out. Lesoa Mbaka nails a three. You felt that one was going down the moment she released it. She almost halfway down the floor, back to play defense before it had even hit the bucket. Stolen away again, no, held on to. Pass inside is good, the finish is not so good. Stankovic trying to bully away to the basket. Has it ripped away, though? Stankovic not quite found the pace or the rhythm of this game yet. Smalls comes back out. Soa Mbaka will draw the foul. Just slightly late footwork from Gerchen. And Soa Mbaka will go to the line. 61% from the free throw line. Part of that. Coach Meziat, Belgium team, romping their way to the Eurobasket Women's Trophy in the summer of last year. It's the first to go. And the second is good. That is smart play. Anishak feeds it to the high post. Fraser trying to find some space. There is no space. To be fair, she does get away a good shot. Just doesn't get it to go, though. Little hesitation. Drives inside. That is a tough, tough play. Once again, this time Zelos will get the score. 5 points personal. 2 from 5 from the field for Siobhante Zelos. Oh, spin move to the bucket. Stephanie Mavunga getting us in a spin. So on Baka, not this time. Has come on the floor and certainly had an offensive impact. 6 points from the 22-year-old. Gaida now hands it off to Fraser. Patience here by Polkowice. On the roll, no good. Villeneuve to ask, managed just to rotate well enough. Three ball goes up from the top and more money raining down from Kennedy Burke. Timeout called by Coach Kowalewski, 31-23. Coach Kowalewski needs to stem the flow and change the game. Let's head into his huddle. Updates from around Europe. We are getting close to the final quarter in the two key games in Group A as Zaragoza take on Lublin and Valencia go up against the Italian team Schio. Valencia doing what they can. They lead by 30 with just 12 minutes of game left. However, Zaragoza just need to win to claim that last spot in Group A, and they are up by 31 points. With 8 seconds left in the third quarter, I think it's fair to say that Zaragoza will lock out that fourth spot. So it will be Fenerbahce, DBTK, Schio and Zaragoza heading through from Group A to the quarterfinals alongside Praha, Chukarova and potentially one of our two teams here. Down into the low post now. Spin move, defense plays a strong hand. Officials call the foul on Burke. Yeah, arms are just forward, not straight up. That will send Fraser to the line for free throws. First is good for Brianna Fraser. And the second, first player to double digits. 10 points, four rebounds for Fraser. A little bit of full court pressure here from Polkowice. A 1-2-1-1 zone press. Not going to lie, anyone that's ever been coached by me knows that's one of my favourite go-tos. Three ball goes up and rattles home. Kennedy Burke has absolutely found a shooting shoes here today. 11 points now for Burke. 4 from 5 from the field. Sykes waits for the screen from Mavunga. Throws the lob pass into Fraser. Not and one. Zealous will be called for the foul. Maybe a little late on the rotation. Let's have a look. Yeah, step too late. Needed to be there earlier. I think she realized that. Fraser back at the line again. Certainly big name starting to step up now. Burke 3 from 4 from outside towards her 11 points. And Fraser doing a great job from the free throw line. 7 from 8 so far. About 8 from 9. Keeping Polkowice within striking distance, but they still trail by 7. Villeneuve Dask will be more than happy with where they're at right now. Just to remember, for the French team, Villeneuve Dask, they just need to win the game, a win, and they qualify for the quarterfinals. Polkowice, a win pretty much gets them there, but doesn't quite get them across the line. But Polkowice, a win will get them there unless Virtus Bologna and Avenida both lose. Then they will go out. Polkowice with possession. About halfway through this second quarter. Fraser now. Oh, lovely little backdoor cut. Pass can't quite thread the eye of the needle. And Salone kicks it away. Sykes now in possession, kicks it out. Frischkovets will drive to the basket. Door closed on her by Zealous though. Mavunga with the offensive rebound. Steps through, door shut, fades away. Stephanie Mavunga has a locker room full of tricks and skill to just be able to get buckets whenever she wants. Timeout called here by Coach Mezia as Polkowice start to fight their way back in. Home team's lead is down to just 5. As you would expect from Coach Mezia, unflustered business approach, changing the details, altering the game plan. As Coach Kovalevsky tries to grab every last second with his team that he can. Baseline ball for Villeneuve Dask. Polkowice now applying a little bit of full court pressure here. That's quickly broken. And the home team will make them pay, not this time. Rebound by Baric. Lovely outlet pass to Mavunga. Great vision there by Nika Baric. Polkowice now just within 3. Lead has been as big as 9. Foul called on Smalls. Reaching over the back of Baric. And Villeneuve d'Ascq are in the penalty. So that will see us walk all the way to the other end of the floor for Nika Baric to shoot free throws. 80% free throw shooter, the Slovenian international. First is no good. Second is long outlet pass. Oh, but the pass to the trail is misguided. Polkowice a chance to tie the game, maybe even take the lead here. Sykes kicks it out wide open. Offensive foul is going to be called on Sykes, though. Had a bit of a slow phase of the game here, neither team getting things done. Small stepping across and drawing the foul off Sykes. Almost stolen away. Foul called on Mavunga. Official starting to tighten up the foul calls now. Calling a lot of the contact. Both teams in the penalty. Still 3:45 left in this second quarter. Remember, Villeneuve d'Ascq entered this second quarter up by two. They're still up by two. Three ball no good for Salone. Maric into the low post. Fraser too heavy. Looks at a foul, no call. Frenetic phase here. Neither team really spending time building their offense. Drive to the basket by Smalls is good. Uses that little body contact onto Mavunga to create the space and separation she needs. Frischkovets. Baric now at the top. Got the mismatch. Doesn't use it though. Frischkovets will drive inside. Feeds it to Mavunga. Drop step off the glass. No good. Interior defense from both teams is very, very strong right now. Villeneuve d'Ascq just flooding the paint to make it a very, very difficult day at the office for Polkowice's bigs. Baseline drive though. That opens up. Zealous can't get it to go. And scoring has slowed down here. Baric for three. No. Another defensive rebound. And you feel if either of these teams can just grab this game by the scruff of the neck for the final, 2 minutes or so before the half, they could come away with a bit of a lead. Zealous comes back. Salone rattles home a three, and in the blink of an eye, Villeneuve d'Ascq are up by seven again. Home team have ridden the storm from Polkowice and extended that lead. Quite a high scoring game for both of these teams. Fraser now back into the low post. Goes to work against Burke. Burke does a good enough job to provide resistance in that low post. Three ball from way downtown. That's an air ball. A rash decision by Kennedy Burke. Oyo will come back in as Camilla Smalls heads to the bench. Coach Meziat rotating well through his roster. Gajda and Stankovic have come in for Polkowice as Fraser and Baric have gone to the bench. Foul to be called there on Kennedy Burke. That's going to see her head to the bench and sub out. Or is it? And just steps in a little too close. the game returns Betty Manunga, another one of the Belgians in Coach Mezian's team. At the line though, Sykes for two. Misses the first. Had a strong game so far, Brittany Sykes, 8 points, 4 from 6 from the field. Gets the second to go. Elio, another press here from Polkowice. Doesn't get the turnover. Salon wide open for three. No good. Where's the rebound? It's in the hands of Sykes. She'll spark the offense. Hesitation off the glass. Another two. Sykes up to 11 points, leading the scoring for Polkowice. Coach Mezian calls a timeout. 54 seconds left in his first half. His team lead by just 4. Coach Mezian showing some frustrations at this team. Keep opening up a 7-9 point lead and then leaving the door open for Polkowice just to barrel their way back in. Sure he's asking his team to be a bit more ruthless, a bit more disciplined than they have been. seconds left in the first half. Elio brings it up over the half. Into the hands of Zealous. Down low now to Diaby. Strong move. That is just power against Stankovic. It takes a lot to move Dragana Stankovic, but she was shrugged to one side there. No score though, and Sykes will take control. 13 second differential, shot clock, first half clock. Dragana Stankovic has really struggled to establish in today's game. Yet to put a point on the board, averaging 9.5 a game this season. Has played in every single game for Polkowice, including the 2 qualifiers. Elio uses the horn set up at the top. Screen the screener. Comes around to Salone. Shot clock down to 3. Salone will draw the foul from Stankovic. Earns herself a trip to the free throw line. Another great free throw shooter for Villeneuve d'Ascq. They're not a great team as a whole, just 73%, but Salone is 87%. Diaby comes out of the game, grab a slightly prolonged halftime break. In her place comes Aminata Gay. First rattles home as Villeneuve d'Ascq try and open up as big a lead as they can for the halftime break. The second is good as well. Sykes now. We'll get it away from the half. No good. And that is the end of the first half here in France. Game day 14. The halftime score is Villeneuve d'Ascq 41, Polkowice 35. As both these teams battle it out in a do or die game for a spot in the postseason playoff quarterfinals. Second half just around the corner. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back with all the live action shortly. Chers amis partenaires, je regarde attention, juste 10 secondes, mesdames et messieurs. Il y avait, souvenez-vous, une mise aux enchères des maillots de Octobre Rose. Les maillots ont été mis aux enchères, vous les avez achetés. Et ce soir, le chèque est remis à l'association d'Octobre Rose. On va leur demander de bien vouloir venir avec nous sur le parquet. Et mesdames et messieurs, un chèque de 2 500 euros. sees them pick up the final quarterfinal berth in Group A. But who cares about Group A? It's Group B we're focused on here in France this evening. At the half, Villeneuve d'Ascq lead by six. Drive to the basket. Does all the hard work. Can't get the score though. Home team hold on to that 6-point lead. Zealous with the jumper, no good. Mavunga grabs the rebound, her sixth rebound of the game. Sykes now uses the screen from Fraser. Fraser wrestling down low. Foul will be called on Salone. Just gets caught in that mismatch. Not giving up much height, but certainly giving up a lot of power in that matchup with Fraser. Salone more of a three. Fraser absolutely a four. Baric now. Mavunga to Sykes. Sykes pulling all the strings again for Polkowice this evening. Baric will have to put a huge three ball up as the shot clock was expiring. They'll get the offensive rebound. Sykes with the three, no good. Mavunga trying to fight for another rebound, but it falls into the hands of Burke. Wide open, Smalls kicks it to Zealous for the three on the wing, rattles it home, and a game-high 9-point lead for Villeneuve d'Ascq. That is exactly what Coach Meziat will have asked of his team. Push hard early in this third quarter, try and kill the game. Frischkowitz falls over. We'll end up turning the ball over. Just loses her footing. Almost too quick for her own feet. Another chance now for the home team to open up what would be the first double-digit lead of the game for either team. Smalls brings the ball up over the half. Three ball goes up and he's good from Zealous. What a start to this second half for the home team. A 6-0 run to get things underway. Put Polkowice on the back foot. Baric with a poor choice offensively. Smalls now. Feeds it to the low post and ends up on the hardwood. Jump ball called as Diaby and Fraser lock it up. Fraser was not going to let go of that one. Baseline ball as the possession arrow points in favour of Villeneuve d'Ascq. Oh, the pass is poor from Smalls. Just a miscommunication between Zealous and Smalls. Turnover ball. Sykes inbounds it long to Baric. Pass inside to Fraser's too heavy from Mnanga. And early mistakes here, and you wonder, is it the pressure starting to pile on our visitors? Polkowice, some cracks starting to show. Foul called. Baric just caught with hands on Zealous. Salone hands it back to Zealous. Press defense here by Sykes, putting plenty of energy on that pressure on the ball. And it's rejected, it'll be a shot clock violation. Good defense by Polkowice, and Neither of these teams really known for their defensive presence. Polkowice, 13th best defense in the competition this season, averaging, well, almost 76 points a game that they concede. So they'll certainly have to keep Villeneuve d'Ascq below that run rate this evening if they want to come back into this one. Three ball goes up. That's short, though. Baric with the rebound. Tries to put a bit of energy into transition. Manunga, step back. A little heavy and an easy rebound from Diaby. Zealous now. Long skip pass to Salone. Oh, a little sidestep. Three ball! What a play! Janelle Salone. 4-point play opportunity for the 22-year-old. Look at this. Oh, love the step back. That footwork is a thing of beauty. Draws the defender in. Stays focused. Gets the points. Draws the foul. A 15-point lead now for Villeneuve d'Ascq. Coach Kovalevsky calls a timeout as his team's chances of making the playoff are starting to shake. Well, Coach Kovalevsky knows that his team cannot afford to let it slide anymore. They have been on the wrong side of a 9-0 start to the second half from Villeneuve d'Ascq. At the line, Salone with a chance of a 4-point play. Gets the bonus, a 16-point lead now for the home team. By the looks of some of the other games that are shaping up around Europe as we speak, the winner of this is likely to secure a spot in the playoffs. Likely, by the looks of it as well, to be joined by Avenida. Foul called. Avenida currently lead by 24 points over Gjorde, and a little under 13 minutes left on the game clock. Avenida win and they qualify. So it looks as it stands right now that it will be Avenida at Villeneuve d'Ascq, Chukarova and Praha. The four teams going through from Group B, but this is the game where it's all up in the air. Sykes hits the first and the second. Steady nerves indeed from the 29-year-old. Into the game comes Gaida. A bit more experience on the floor now for Polkowice. A really loose press defense. Polkowice sitting in this zone. Oh, that's a poor pass. Easily intercepted by Mavunga. Gaida will hand it back. Mavunga turns the corner. The defense is all over her. Draws the foul. Let's have a look at the replay. Yeah, I'd say body or the arm really on that one. Take your pick on which foul you want to call. Mavunga will go to the line. It's the first 91% free throw shooter. Stephanie Mavunga takes her tally up to 10 for the night alongside 6 rebounds and the second. And the first 4 points of the second half of Polkowice all come from the free throw line. Pretty sure sure Coach Kowalewski and the Polkowice fans couldn't care less where they come from right now, as long as they start coming. Three ball from Zeller, string music from the top. And Villeneuve to ask now in a different position. It's about trying to maintain enough of a lead to keep the pressure off them. Gaida kicks it out to Gertchen. Gertchen too heavy. Rebound falls kindly to Salone. Her fourth rebound of the game. Foul's going to be called, I think, on Gertchen. Out of the game comes Burke. Into the game comes Diaby. In fact, sorry, Betty Manunga comes in. Foul called on the drive. Let's have a look at the replay. Yeah, it's the right call. Stephanie Mavunga coming from the weak side and bodying the drive. Substitution here for Polkowice. Out of the game comes Fraser. Stankovic comes back in. Both coaches playing the chess game, moving the pieces around, trying to get the right rotations on the floor. But as it stands, Villeneuve d'Ascq lead by 15 here. And under 15 to play. Both free throws are good from the line. For Smalls, she heads to the bench as Alio comes in her place. You feel that the first task for Coach Mezian and his team is if they can hold on to a 15-point lead at the end of the quarter. They're in the driving seat. Salone. Been a real standout performance. Foul called on Sykes. Salone will go to the line for two shots. Let's have a look at the replay. Tough to see from that angle at that pace. The score here in the third quarter. The French team really have come out of the locker room at the half full of, I don't know, focus, I suppose you'd call it. It's not necessarily a higher intensity or higher energy levels, just really disciplined basketball being put on show by the French team. And their lead now out to 19. We're getting close to the point of no return for Polkowice. Elio guarding Gaida. Sykes comes back to pick it up, and she is, for me, the best person to have the ball in her hands for Polkowice. She's the one that creates the offense at the highest level. Will draw the foul. A little bit of sweat on the floor that needs mopping up. Polkowice are in the penalty, as are Villeneuve d'Ascq. Neither team have been shy with giving up their fouls. The officials, to be fair, have called this game very tight. They are locking down on any of the physicality, any of the little bumps or hand checks the officials are calling out. We're gonna see Diaby head to the bench for Gay come back in. For Villeneuve d'Ascq. Gaida now. Mavunga. Lovely pass. Stankovic. Baseline cut. Goes back door. Gets the two. Her first points of the game. Still a 17-point lead, though, for the home team. Stolen away. Gaida. Will draw the foul from Gee. Yeah, much more straightforward a call for the officials than that. And that will send Guider all the other way, all the way to the other end of the floor. Both teams in the penalty. Guider, 78% free throw shooter. Bit of a fixture and fitting here at Polkowice. She's been here since 2017. 35 years old. The way she plays the game, you wouldn't say it. Polkowice back in this press defense. More to slow Villeneuve Dask down, and I'm not sure that's wise. Time is on the side of the French team. Surely they want to try and push them to play faster basketball. Aureo called for the travel. Sykes now brings it up over the half and hands it away. A little bit more urgency needed from Polkowice. Stankovic, a bit more direct, but once again throws it away. She has had a tough night at the office, Dragana Stankovic. Serbian international just hasn't managed to get a foothold in this game. Aujo. Salon really finding some confidence. She's had a great game so far. 11 points, 4 rebounds. Alvio trying to find a way around. She'll step back. Jumper no good, though. Rebound pulled down by Agui. Bullying away to the basket. Will draw the foul as she's pinned to the floor by both Mavonga and Gaida. Line for two. First, no good. Mavunga called for the foul. At the line for the second. That one's good to go. Villeneuve Dask lead back up to 16 as Coach Mezian continues to push. Knows this game isn't been put to bed just yet. This team certainly have made big strides in this quarter, though, that's for sure. They've won every quarter so far, the first by two, the second by four. They lead by 10 in this quarter. Rebound, Salon. Alio. Foul going to be called on Fraser. Off the ball in the low post, I think maybe hands on. Yeah, pushing violation call. Plenty of foul calls in this game. The officials aren't letting anything go. Gee back at the line for two. First is good. Into the game. Returns the Soren backer as Salone takes a well-earned break. 2 minutes and 10 seconds left in the third. Gaida into the low post. Strength by Fraser. Will get the roll and just the aggression and determination, I think, won of that bucket. Pass inside from Lissou Mbaka. Gay can get it, gets the O-board and gets the two on the putback. Starting to look a little bit too easy for the home team now. Could this be the end of the road, the end of the European adventure for Polkowice this year? Stankovic comes barreling down the paint to get the two. Harassing Zealous. Zealous for three. No call. Off the ball, I think it was. Gaida called for the foul. in the penalty. Guider waves away the officials. Not sure who that will send to the line. They want to review. Not sure what they want to review for. To see which player was fouled. Or are they reviewing to see if it should be upgraded to an unsportsmanlike? The elbow does go high, but I think it's more unintentional. No, I think they were just checking who the foul was on. Manunga is at the line, misses the first of her two. Plenty of changes here for Polkowice. As we see Pistrzyniska come in and Mavunga come in for Sykes and Stankovic. Gertchen. Foul called on Manunga against Fraser. Teams both know that can't get away with any physical contact in this one. That will send Fraser to the line, and what has been a very long final couple of minutes to this quarter with whistles continuously echoing around the arena. Fraser misses the first of her two, though. 14 points this evening for Brianna Fraser. Not the most efficient, just 3 from 9 from the field. Doesn't get either free throw to go either. And it's still a 16-point lead for Villeneuve d'Ascq. We're deep into the final minute of the quarter. Isoa Mbaka hands it inside, comes back out. Smalls weaving away through. Shot clock down to 3, and it's stolen away. Gertchen now. About a 6-second differential between the quarter clock and the shot clock. Mavunga comes back out. Gaida doesn't take the jumper, pulls in for the short 2 and gets it to go. Smart play by Veronica Gaida. As Villeneuve d'Ascq will look to take the final shot of the quarter. Smalls calls for the screen. Dives inside, off the glass, and gets the points. That is the way they wanted to close out what has been a very, very impressive quarter of basketball from Villeneuve d'Ascq. Look at the smiles all around for the team in white. With 1 quarter left to play, they lead by 16. They are so, so close to booking a spot in the EuroLeague Women quarterfinals. Just 10 minutes of basketball left in the regular season. Villeneuve d'Ascq lead this one 65-49 over Polkowice. The French team 1 foot in the quarterfinals. Can they close this one out? Or can the Polish team cause what would be an unbelievable upset with a huge comeback? Gertchen now feeds the low post. Mavunga going to work. Defense all over her. She's going to keep going though. Rebound pulled down by Fraser. Double team drops in on Fraser. Skip pass out. Gaida calls for the screen. Will draw the foul from Alio. Gertchen looks for the roll of Mavunga, easily intercepted. It's a poor lofted pass. Alio puts the Jets on. Oh my goodness me, Caroline Alio! What a shot! Have a look, a little bit of the three-on-three experience that she brings to floor. Pace, aggression, a little bit of flair as well. Shaking and baking, takes the contact and gets the score. Wonderful play. That's the bonus, a 19-point lead now for the home team. Conversation to both Gai and Mavunga, getting caught up in the paint. Rightfully so, Amaneta Gai doesn't want to get involved. Her team lead, doesn't want to shake that up. Fraser now to Mavunga. Into Gaida. Jumper goes up and is good. That is a very smart play. Kostolinska hits a three. Hasn't been on the floor very much, just 2 minutes, but that is a way to help your team. Alvio hands it away. Patience needed now for the home team. Polkowice sitting in a 2-3 zone. Lisua Mbaka goes on the reverse, will come away with the offensive rebound though. Fresh 14 for Villeneuve d'Ascq. Offensive foul though called on Amaneta Gui. Wouldn't be surprised if we see Coach Mezian take her in out of the game. Maybe the emotion's getting a little bit too much right now. Gaida. Fraser to Mavunga. Gaida turns the corner, will come back out. Shot clock down to 5. Fraser, oh, spin move. Won't get the score, will draw the foul. Lovely footwork from Brianna Fraser. Just flowing away to the basket. A little bit of a heated discussion here between Gai and Mavunga. They both get technical fouls. I'm surprised Coach Mezian didn't take her out of the game. She was clearly losing her head a little bit with it all. Double technical foul cancels each out. Burke and Diaby have come in as Mananga and Gai have come out for Villeneuve d'Ascq. Mavunga still on the floor. Yeah, no free throws for the technicals on a double tech. Fraser at the line. Frischkovets has come back in for Polkowice as well. Getting some shooting. Going to be a big part of any recovery strategy for Polkowice. Free throw miss though. Still a 16-point lead for Villeneuve d'Ascq. Lovely crossover. Hands it off inside, and the two is good for Kariata Diaby, and stolen away. Burke will slow it down. Time management now is going to be part of the game for Villeneuve d'Ascq. Kicked out, three ball goes up. String music from the wing. This time Lissou Mbaka. And everything is going the way of the French team as they open out their first 20-point lead of the game. The home crowd are partying their way into the quarterfinals right now. Polkowice, no answers. Fraser will throw it up. Hits a three, nonchalant from Brianna Fraser. Poor on-ball defense, if you're critical there, of Villeneuve d'Ascq. Smalls now, trying to find a lane to attack. Skip ball, shot clock to four. Comes out, Alio's going to have to throw it up. She does. Hits the iron and they'll recover. And it's your day, it's your day. Rebounds falling kindly to the home team. Alio, step back three, it's good. Caroline Alio putting on a show. That one's thrown out of bounds. Another change coming from Coach Mezia. Zealous will come into the game. Alio comes out. What an impact she's had here in this closing stages of the game. Polkowice a ball on the sideline, under 6.5 minutes to play. Just a break in play right now. Gaida coming out of the game. Skip past the Frischkovets, and Polkowice are still patient. Probably need a little bit more urgency. Frischkovets with the three, no good. Ball down low to Fraser. And she just keeps battling Brianna Fraser. Got to give her a huge amount of credit. 20 points now for Fraser alongside five rebounds. Three ball goes up. That one's a little flat. Stankovic out-rebounded by Lissoua Mbaka. Oh, goes to the up and under. Not this time, though. And again, no good. Villeneuve d'Ascq losing a little bit of that golden touch on the offensive end. Fraser, biggest offensive threat alongside Sykes this evening for Polkowice. Sykes will get the three ball up and draw the foul from Lissoua Mbaka. Belgian international just going under the feet of Sykes. That is a dangerous place to be. So I think the officials have been told to look out for quite, well, a couple of seasons now. Alio will come back in for Villeneuve d'Ascq as Smalls heads to the bench. Officials are going to go and review the footage. I'm not sure whether they're considering to upgrade the foul. Yeah, I think they are trying to see if they consider this to be an unsportsmanlike foul.
The first one. Okay, this one. Look at this side of the ball. I mean, this is the premier.
The angle will help them make their decision, the static.
Okay, thank you.
Interesting to see if they do upgrade this to an unsportsmanlike foul. They are going to. That will give two shots to Sykes and Polkowice will take possession. Is that a glimmer of light away back into this game? If they can fully capitalize, it could be. Could be a 5-point swing here. First is no good for Sykes, and it just shows you even the highest level, most experienced athletes sometimes feel the pressure. The second is good. Sykes will have a third shot. Polkowice will get possession as well. Two from three for Sykes from the line. 15-point lead for Villeneuve d'Ascq. 5:21 left on the game clock. Still doable. It's an outside chance, but plenty of firepower in this Polkowice roster. Sykes fades away. That's a tough shot. Ironing away. Fraser hustling hard as she knows how. Sykes, another jumper. That one's too heavy. This time the rebound is pulled down by Diaby. Zealous will slow it down. Shot clock at 8, though. Salone draws the foul off Sykes. It's nowhere near the penalty just yet. Yeah, it's that right hand on the hip. Coach Kovalevsky was hoping for so much more from his team this evening. Defensively, they've struggled to stop Villeneuve d'Ascq, and there's a prime example of how they've struggled as Diaby gets an easy score off the glass. Just 4 points for Diaby this evening. Rishkovets inside now to Fraser. Fraser will just pull up on the little mid-range jumper, and you almost feel that Brianna Fraser is taking this as a personal affront, a personal challenge. She's up to 22 now. Three rebounds shy of a double-double. Zealous inside. Oh, and that defense will win you no games whatsoever. And Polkowice have struggled this season defensively. They have struggled to contain teams. They have relied on outscoring the teams they face. And tonight, that is not going to go their way as they're facing a French Villeneuve d'Ascq who has a lot of firepower in the locker. Timeout call by Coach Kovalevsky. Let's head into that huddle. Avenida picking up a low-scoring 56-42 win over Pure. That is enough for Avenida to make it through to the playoffs. So our final spot is here. The winner of today's game takes the fourth and final quarterfinal spot here in Group B. In fact, the eighth and final quarterfinal spot across the entire competition. As it stands, Villeneuve d'Ascq in the driving seat, but Polkowice will not go quietly. Frischkovets hits a big three. They're back within 14. Three ball goes up from the wing. That's off target. Stankovic can only bat it back though. Fresh 14 for Villeneuve d'Ascq. Salone step back jumper. Short corner two is good. What a game Janelle Salone has had. 13 points now, 5 rebounds. Just one shy of her season high scoring. Foul's going to be called. Burke called for the foul against Fraser. Just gets caught with a hand in the cookie jar. Fraser at the line. Fraser, one of very few Polkowice players that has played up to the expectation this evening, if not beyond. 23 points now for Brianna Fraser, 6 from 12 from the field, as well as 7 rebounds. Gets them both to go. 14-point lead for Villeneuve d'Ascq. Zealous, that's off short. Alio grabs the rebound, a fresh 14 again for the French team. Double team comes across. Polkowice gonna double now. Need to really change the game. Rebound almost pulled down by Fraser. It will be Polkowice ball though. Crowd don't like it. Haven't had much to moan about this evening. The game has gone pretty much the home team's way throughout. I'm not talking about calls from the officials. I'm just talking generally. Just want to review who that came off. Look, it may have been Fraser. Tough to see. Need to slow that one down. No, for me, that isn't off Fraser. The official's got it right first time. Ah, this could be a good angle. Yeah, no, that's off the hand of Diaby for me.
This camera is too different.
The officials are going to stay with their original call. They are. Polkowice ball. Baseline ball for the Polish team. Now to inbound. 2.5 minutes left on the game clock. Is there 2.5 minutes of Polkowice's European campaign left? Will Villeneuve d'Ascq head towards the playoffs, which tip off on the 21st of February? Sykes, free throw line, will draw the foul and one. A little bit of marmalade on that toast. Great defense by Salone. Just better offense from Sykes, simple as that. The lead is down to just 11 points. Coach Mezian will make a change. Smalls comes in, Alio goes to the bench. Nervous times here in France. Villeneuve d'Ascq surely just want to run some clock down now. Need to get it up over the half. They do. Salone. Polkowice are still in this zone. Lovely shovel pass inside. The score's no good. Another offensive rebound. Stankovic called for the foul. She says she got all ball. Sure about that. That arm is very far stretched forward. Looks like it hit a lot of the arm of Burke. Big free throws. First is good for Kennedy Burke. 13.6 rebounds, 4 assists. Making dents in all the columns of the box score. Misses the second though. Still a 12-point lead. Urgency needed now from Polkowice. They don't have time. They need to go early. Sykes, remember, a win is what they need. The winner of today's game here will go to the quarterfinals. Oh, that's a brick from Frischkowitz. 90 seconds left. Is that enough? Will Villeneuve d'Ascq secure the 8th and final quarterfinal spot? Smalls for 3, it's off left. Not sure it came away with anything. Almost thrown away by Stankovic though, and that may have summed her day up a little. 1 minute 10 to play. It's a party atmosphere here in Villeneuve d'Ascq. Offensive foul is going to be called on Sykes as she knocks Salone to the floor. Sykes is frustrated with the official. Good defense by Salone. Sykes out of the game, having words with the officials on a way out. Not sure that's too smart. Timeout's going to be called. In fact, no, the official says no. I've given the ball. You can't have a timeout once I've handed the ball away. Coach Mezzi out wanting a timeout. He's not going to get one. Zealous to inbound the ball. Surely the home team will just run the clock now. No pressure being applied by from Polkowice at all. Have they conceded? Out of bounds though, turnover. I don't know why they're still sitting in a zone defense with no pressure being applied. They absolutely still had a chance. Baric, no urgency offensively. You feel that Polkowice have conceded, but it will be Villeneuve d'Ascq who take that final quarter-final berth for this year's EuroLeague Women. Stankovic will get the score. Brings them to within 10. 40 seconds left on the game clock. Frischkovets working as hard as she can, but no one else really joining her. Corner three, Zealous for three, and the party can start here in Villeneuve d'Ascq. They are on their way to the postseason. They are on their way to the playoffs. An impressive business-like performance from Coach Mezier and his team. They have come here and got the job done. Tough, tough, pressure situation. With the crowd behind them, though, it will be Villeneuve d'Ascq who secure a spot in this year's EuroLeague Women quarterfinals. They come away 85-72 winners, and they will be in the quarterfinals. Those games tip off 21st of February, second leg on the 28th, and if we need a third game in that series, it will be on the 6th of March. What a game we've had here this evening. What a way to close out the regular season. Villeneuve d'Ascq come away with a 85-72 point win over Polkowice. The Polish team's European adventure is over for this season, whilst the French team's postseason game is just around the corner. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you've enjoyed today's game as much as I have, and I hope you'll join me in a few weeks' time for those quarterfinals. There are some big matchups just down the road as we build towards this year's EuroLeague Women Final Fours.
Je vous demande un peu de la hauteur de l'événement ce soir. Yeah.